Hey there, folks, this is David on David's Brain. Welcome back to our ongoing Let's Play of Control for the PS4 on PS5. Please be sure to like, share, subscribe, comment, ring the bell, contribute to my Patreon, links in the description to the bottom, stay inside, stay safe, wear a mask, get vaccinated, and yeah, we have officially reached our, well, yeah, cue the American Dad clip. The all is lost moment! Yeah, we found Polaris inside Dimensional Research, and yeah, unfortunately, that just let Dylan and the Hiss right to it. So, yeah, Polaris is gone, Jesse's being subsumed by the Hiss, and apparently we're getting some information here that, yeah, apparently when, Trench and Darling led the expedition into the slide for the slide projector, the Hiss latched onto Trench's mind, and he was the one who set the Hiss loose inside the Bureau. Because he thought that Polaris, or Hedron, Polaris, yeah, since Polaris was whispering to Darling, Trench thought that the Hiss were the benevolent force and Polaris was the evil one. So yeah, this whole thing is entirely Trench's fault. Well, yeah, Trench is dead, and now Dylan's loose so that he and the Hiss can take over. And now Jesse's got to fight her way out through the Hiss, retake control of her body, find Dylan, stop him, and get to, get to the nostalgia division where apparently Trench has secreted away the projector.
I remember it was like this dream I had last night. See, there was this man, here in this very room, and then sometimes he was a plumber unclogging the drain, and because there was a fish stuck there, yeah, a big fish. But sometimes he was an old god, you see, and he had put the fish there in the first place to keep the waste. There was rising waste from leaking out, so he was conflicted. But he knew many things. But he was also sort of senile, like me. It was more like a riddle or an omen. It wasn't a very good one or an interesting one, but I get so confused so easily. It's so very hard to follow everything that's happening.
Tell me about it.
I won't let them win. That's how it happened. The Hiss got Trench first. He turned on the projector. He let them in. I have to remember the Hiss. The Hiss is the enemy. The Hiss burrowing in. I'm trapped in here. They're taking over.
Well, now you're aware of it. Now we can fight back.
None of this is real. I'm not doing this anymore. I need to get to Trench's office. I'm done with this. I'm not your servant. What am I doing? Fuck this shit. This is nonsense. It stops now. What am I doing?
All right, yeah, you know what? Screw this noise.
I need to get to Trench's office.
You need to pick up the service weapon to get that back, to retake control find the Hiss, find Dylan, and get those two out.
I will fight this. I will find a way to push them out.
Welcome back. I knew I chose a good assistant.
Thanks, Ati, or whatever you are. Good to know there's at least one paranatural entity that's on my side.
I need my gun.
Yeah, I've had enough of this. Yeah.
We build you till nothing remains. The egg cracks and the truth will emerge out of you. You are home. You remind us of home. You've taken your boss with you. Your boss with you. Those hair must be eaten. Under the conceptual reality behind this reality, you must want its wings to drag it away. After the song, time for applause. This cliche is death out of time. Breaking one's first, second, third, the fourth, no, number fifth, four, four, no four, you four. How do you say insist? Hurts me happy. An earworm is a tune that can't stop coming. In a dream, deep, yeah. Just last, so sales, and nothing is worrying about. Ha ha! Fun, the last embrace ass. The hole in your room is a hole in you. You came in like you in through the hole in you. You have always been here, the only child, a copy of. Copy! Orange peel. The picture is you holding the picture. When you hear this, you will know it. You're in new you. You want to listen. You want to dream. You want to smile. You want to be hurt. You don't want to be.
Yeah, okay, this is fun and all, but get the hell out of my chair.
I know what I must do. Start at the beginning. I should have seen it earlier. This is my mess to clean up. My fight. No one else's. I am the director.
Hello. This is Dr. Casper Darling. I have a classified message for the director of the Federal Bureau of Control. I have sad news. Hedren is gone now, but it was not a source. It was a catalyst. Do you Understand. You must go to my office, the Endgame. It will be revealed.
All right, find Darling's office. Yeah. I've heard this old song and dance before. Was it good the first time? Yeah, see, an earworm is supposed to be something that's good. This is just repetitive crap. Oh, you think you're being cute? You think you guys are real cute? And Dylan. Oh, we're coming for you, cute ball. All right, let's see. Where is Darling's office? Ah, there you are. All right, time to check in.
You're gone. Dead. I can't feel you. I can't. This is what Dylan wanted all along. Something. I can feel it, but I don't know what. The motel is a place of power, of change, a place to pass through, connecting everything. This is a dream inside my head. Why shouldn't it take me anywhere I want to go?
Alright, let's see. Visit Ordinary, where nothing ever is. Around one constant, they revolve Jesse Faden. And Polaris, grow brighter. A pyramid, heaven, hell.
No matter who I am, what you turned out just the same. There was a knock on the door, a thump on the floor, and the party turned insane as she called out her name.
What the fuck am I looking at?
This is so weird. But it is my head.
Well,
you're such a weirdo, Jesse.
Or maybe you're just finally learning to embrace the madness. And hey, this is your room after all. Okay, so what are you?
Constant. They revolve. Hedron is dead, but you're alive here in me. Maybe Hedron put you in our heads when we met her. Maybe you were always there, and she was just trying to teach me how to trigger you. Maybe I'll never understand. Maybe I don't need to. Trench was the first to be corrupted by the hiss. Slowly, over the years. His need for control only made it worse. It was Trench who took the projector to the nostalgia department. He opened the door to the hiss. Just like that. With Hedron dead, the hiss tried to corrupt me too. But I'm stronger than them. We're stronger. They're waiting. They'll try to stop us.
Ah, untapped potential, jukebox token. So what, Jesse, you just needed like a little pump up battle song or something? That's why he had the whole thing with thing with Darling? Whatever. Multimedia dynamite. All right, Dylan, where the hell are you, asshole?
My sister had this dream, a bad dream, and the whole world was dreaming with her.
Dylan?
She convinced herself that she was awake. She's always been stubborn. I knew I had to end her dream. I had to wake her up. I had to rip down the poster she'd been staring at. Cut off her eyelids to make her see. To save her.
Where are you, asshole? Alright, there's the slide projector. Dylan can't be too far behind.
Somewhere. Locked inside. I know, because that's how it was for me.
Level 30, or is it like... Are you sure it's not 3? That's what the board meant by that power up. Thank you. And remember, Jesse is dynamite. All right, come one, come all, come right over. Never mind. All right, just gotta keep going. Dylan. Oh, shut up.
Dylan's in a coma. I don't know if there's anything of him left in there. If he'll ever find his way back. The portal's been closed. But the hiss is still in the oldest house. And the lockdown can't be lifted as long as any trace of it remains. I'm working on a solution with my management team, but there is still a long road ahead. I'm the director of the Federal Bureau of Control. We're in this together. You and I.
Take control. Director of the FBC. All right, well, wow, that was kind of a bit underwhelming. So, yeah, that was apparently the main campaign of Control. Huh. Alright, well, aside from that ending, the game overall is, yeah, amazing. Oh, right, yeah, probably should be doing this whole wrap-up thing yet. There's still the Foundation DLC to take care of here. And, yeah, hopefully that'll give us a way better ending than what this was. So, yeah, just ignoring all the copyrighted music. Yeah, that's obviously blocked out here. And yeah, right now I am just so grateful that I went through investigations first. Because yeah, if I didn't, I would probably be having a much more difficult time. Yeah. All right, well, just gonna wait for the credits to roll by here. Alright, so yeah, Director Trench was the first to be taken over by the Hiss. He let them in with his paranoia about Darling. And so yeah, this whole thing was Trench's fault. Smooth. And let's see, the Foundation. And, oh, thanks for the spoilers there. We're going to be encountering Dr. Ash, apparently. Or at least hearing anecdotes from him. Okay, credits. I know you have a lot to go through here, but, okay, maybe I should be a little bit more, I should probably, should be complaining that there's nothing going on here, at least, oh. To Mark Bloom, who gave us the original Dr. Hartman, and R.I.P. then. All right, so apparently it was localized over in Eastern markets by Marvelous. Huh. Then again, sounds about right, considering they were also the guys who gave the green light for No More Heroes. Alright, well, anyways, before I go and start off on the Foundation DLC, I'm probably going to give one last big overall grand sweep of the entire Bureau. Yeah, just make sure I didn't miss anything. Oh, this is awkward and uncomfortable. Alright, so yeah, the hits are still inside the Bureau. And yeah, hopefully we'll clear them out during the Foundation DLC, or at least take out a good chunk of them. And yeah, manage to lock up the Slide Projector. So hopefully the hiss will be finally cleared out by the time of Control 2, or if the Bureau decides to show up at any time during the events of Alan Wake 2. Yeah, we'll see. Wait, Hideo Kojima? What was Kojima involved with this? All right. Or what, did Kojima inspire a lot of stuff in here? Event, Fear of a Blank Planet, Dynamite, Take Control, My Dark Disquiet, Heroes Tangle, Lithe, Artificial Light, Cosmic Debris, Salmon Soup, Beneath, Cold Goodbyes, Relinquished, Watching Darkness Come and Go, Spawn, Devouring the Devoted, Transient Love, and Constrain. Yeah, sounds like some interesting music here, but again, I figured out what happens if you start playing some of them here, so. Alright, anyways, credits finally over, yay. You're now the director of the Federal Bureau of Control. The crisis is not over, your work is not done. And yep, here's Jesse and her new. And yeah, her outfit is the director. Execute board countermeasures of Bureau alerts to fight the ongoing hiss threat. Search the dangerous depths of the oldest house for classified Bureau secrets and hidden clues. All right, let's see here. The hotline. The endless grid from Trench. The endless grind.
My reflection trapped in the darkness of the coffee I nurse. The rain turned the lights of the city into a mosaic on the windows. The day's paper lists all the things wrong in the world. The list grows longer by the day. The difference between the morning and the night. Coffee. whiskey. No other difference. The alarm goes off at 5 a.m. It feels like I just closed my eyes. It's dark. I sit up on the bed in the gloom. I get up, I shower. The driver waits for me downstairs, takes me to the oldest house. An old man stares at me in the car window. It's raining. It's dark. Late at night, he brings me back here. It's not a home. It's a room where I sleep in, waking up just as tired as I was before going to bed. Endless grind.
And that was the hole that the hiss used to get in. Oh, and let's hear what the board has to say. Talk to you in the expansion, eh? Subtle. Alright, research and records. Director Faden. I'm the director of the Federal Bureau of Control, Jesse Faden. And finally, the Slide Projector. Let's see. Description. This object is a... with a vertical tray. The object creates... see Dr. Darley presentation 26.1 for more details. It only... to successfully produce this effect resulted in the capture of... see Dr. Darling presentation. Yeah. Object has not been successfully bound. The per-utility of this object does not require binding. Discovered when the Bureau responded to... see AWE-24 case for more information. Many of the accompanying were C-files on P6 and P7. The entirety of the... was transported to the Bureau for examination to find additional or other altered materials. Yeah, the entirety of of ordinary.
Shawshank Redemption.
Yep.
That's the name of the movie I was thinking of earlier.
There you go.
Not important, but that was it.
Yeah, that's what you're thinking of, the Shawshank Redemption. Yep. Yep, director Jesse Faden. Yeah, the Foundation. Yeah, we'll start on that next time, but first, want to do a little victory lap. Yeah, I'm gonna have to get my new Jesse. You're gonna have to get your new management team up and running. Yep, director on deck here.
Any luck finding the armory?
None. Looks like it got shifted. We have rangers checking each sector.
Fuck, whose side is the house on? Alright, we'll keep teams looking. And post a watch on the old location just in case it shifts back. We need that fucking ammo. I heard you closed the hiss portal, or whatever it is we're calling it. Now if we could just flush out the stragglers.
Yeah, we'll figure that out. So, Arish. Feel up for a promotion?
So, what's next for Simon Arish?
Well, first off, I'm bad at all slide projectors. That's it.
Yeah.
Seriously, though, we need to review our protocols. Research should not be making decisions that endanger the entire Bureau, but fuck it, the entire fucking world, without some serious oversight.
I think Pope would agree. Certain people in the Bureau have been working in the shadows for too long.
And I'd like to make these HRAs part of the mandatory Bureau uniform. They're not stylish, but better safe than sorry.
I hear ya.
Anyone will complain. Not after this.
Alright, so, I'm the director. Jesse's the director now. What do you think?
What are thoughts on me serving as director?
Well, I couldn't be more excited. I mean, look, don't get me wrong, Trench was fine, but you pulled us back from the brink, so... Well, I'm honored to serve, ma'am. I mean, fuck, shit. Faden. Sorry.
He'll get it one day.
Yeah, just give it time. Alright, anyways, what's going on?
So, what's the situation in my bureau, Arish?
The situation is we are still up to our eyes in his. Not to mention the months of repairs it's gonna take just to get this place up and running again.
But is it doable?
Of course it is. You just might need to tell some rangers to grab a wrench once they're done hunting his.
That'll work. Alright, so yeah, speaking of the slide projector, where is that thing?
Did anyone ever mention to you that Darling was using the slide projector?
Well, Salvador never did, but I doubt he even knew. Look, I'm well aware that it's our job to study and contain the things that we don't understand, but some of the things that Darling did were way outside of our mission statement. Look, these things are not toys, and acting like they are is only ever going to end one way. At least Pope seems to understand that.
Well, it's secure now. No one can reach it without my say-so.
But thank Christ for that.
Yeah, no, if it were up to me and if I was able to, I'd just take a hammer to the damn thing. Anyways, any updates on where Marshall scurried off to?
Marshall's been missing for a while now. Any ideas where she could be?
The last time I saw her was in maintenance when I was leading the Rangers out of the Atlas. Yeah, I told her it wasn't safe, but she said she had to go check on something.
Did you ask where she was going?
Whew, Marshall is not the kind of person you question. Kind of intimidating, you know? But, she was by herself. That helps at all.
It does not.
But thanks. Hopefully she turns up.
And hopefully she's still on our side.
I'll see you later.
You know where I'll be.
Alright, upgrade Surge. Surge of Power. Alright, so yeah, I almost thought I was bugged, but yep, nope. Under director suit. Office assistant, yeah, just like Dylan wanted. Or what the hiss possessing Dylan wanted, I don't know. Ugh. Alright, let's see, what should I go for? Screw it. Alright, so, Miss Pope.
Or is the distinction itself a fallacy?
Let's see. Variants and alterations. Compiled by Pope. Let's see. Analysis of his threat, part 5. His corruption manifests in vastly different ways. Some hosts remain largely unchanged, while others are barely recognizable as human. What determines this level of alteration? Is it the duration of corruption? It could simply be an evolutionary process, each entity representing a stage of growth and an undiscovered linear progression leaning towards... what? Additionally, his entities possess various paranatural abilities. How have they achieved this? Did they gain them from corrupting objects of power? Have they corrupted a single, highly talented para-utilitarian and divided their access to paranatural abilities across the network of his corrupted hosts? Well, considering their first possessor was Director Trench, that sounds likely. As a scientist, I am hindered by the sheer number of questions. It's difficult to identify where one should begin. What's the most pertinent question? How do we kill it? That seems like a good start. Alright, Emily.
Jesse, good to see you. We've got Dylan situated in his containment cell like you asked. I've got medical staff running tests as we speak, and I'd be happy to walk you through the details later. Other than that, what's next?
With the slide projector turned off, the hiss are shut out, but we're stuck with the ones already here. We can't lift the lockdown until they're all eradicated. If any hiss ever got out, that would be the end of everything.
Well, eliminating them all will take time. Look, I'll do what I can on my end, but my research is progressing slower than I'd like.
I think I can help with that. I am making you the head of research, effective immediately. I want you to use everything the Bureau has, every resource, every confidential scrap of data, and find a way to keep the hiss out for good.
That's... really?
Yeah, really.
I mean, yes, yes, I can certainly... yes. Yes, I accept.
Hell yeah.
You'll do great. Besides, I didn't really have anyone else lined up.
I'm honored, Jesse, really. Thank you.
I just hope you didn't open up Pandora's box there. I mean, sure, Jesse's... I mean, sure, Emily seems nice, but then again, so did Darling. Ugh.
I've looked through the docs we found in Dimensional Research. That slide projector is extremely powerful. You were right to shut it down.
Alright, so, what do you think of me as director, aside from the one who just gave you a nice big fat promotion?
How do you feel about me taking over as director?
You act like it just happened. You've been director since we first met, remember? I'm still thrilled. Nothing's changed. Not for me. But the Bureau has changed. Trench and Darling are gone. Their knowledge, anything not written down, disappeared with them. They knew the Bureau better than anyone.
They're the Bureau's past, Emily. We won't operate like they did. We'll learn from their mistakes. We'll be better than they ever were. We won't ever be like them.
Well, here's hoping. And yeah, speaking of Darling.
When the hiss got into my head, I saw some weird things. I think Darling even spoke to me. Does that make any sense to you?
Empirically, no, but... phantom voices, as well as hallucinatory states, are not uncommon here. And considering the forces that Dr. Darling was working with, he could have been transferred to a different plane of consciousness, physically or otherwise.
And that doesn't upset you?
Oh, very. The fact that he hid those forces from me? It's infuriating. But Darling's dream was always to look beyond our reality. This time he may have taken a step too far. But as long as his consciousness can perceive his surroundings, I'm sure he's loving it.
Maybe Darling was just trying to protect you from the darker side of his work.
Fuck that. I'm not a child. Like, don't just assume I'm going to consider something morally repugnant.
Which it all was.
Yes.
Which it all was, of course.
Okay, good. Okay, good, good, good. So yeah, unlike Darling, you actually do have a sense of ethics and, you know, actually act like a human being. And speaking of Dylan...
How is Dylan?
The same. I can't detect any his activity, but his physiology has certainly been altered by it. And I can't tell if his brain activity is genuine or simply the aftermath of the hiss, like spasms. Dylan could wake up tomorrow for all I know. I really can't say.
Then I just have to wait for him. That's fair. He waited a long time for me.
Don't worry. We'll be monitoring him round the clock. If he wakes up, we'll be ready. I don't mean that in a hostile way, just... well, you know.
Yeah.
I hear you. My brother isn't exactly popular around here.
Ooh, that's an understatement.
I hope one day he'll have the chance to change that.
Or, if he wakes up and sees you as the new director, he could get even more off the deep end and probably just attack you. Anyways, about the HRAs.
So, there was a moment, after Hedron died, that I couldn't feel my powers. The hiss got into my head. Just for a moment.
So that explains the HRA outage.
Before we knew what was happening, the hiss had us. They were in my head. I saw terrible things. I mean, I was about to go under forever when the hiss was pushed back. The HRAs had come back on. Dylan vanished afterwards, and we fought off the hiss that came after him. So if Hedren's death knocked out the HRAs, that means there must be a new local source for them to relay, which I'm guessing must be...
Polaris.
Me.
You.
Yep.
Hedren is dead, assuming that word even applies to a resonant-based life form. But whatever it awakened in you, the power you call Polaris, is still active. Or at least, that's what my instruments are telling me.
I don't think we're ever gonna understand all of this. And I'm okay with that. I'm just glad you're here with me.
That's good to know. Thanks, Emily.
And lastly, the board.
I found Dylan attacking the astral plane and the board. What was he hoping to accomplish? Huh. Since they arrived, Hiss have been corrupting objects of power, which have an inherent link to the astral plane. Maybe their goal was to access the astral plane and the board itself.
That still doesn't tell us why.
His motives are a difficult thing to work out, but I have been digging through confidential files and noticed a strange gap in knowledge regarding the board. Looks like any data on them has either been deleted or was never gathered in the first place.
Then maybe it's time someone looked into that.
Maybe it is.
Let's just hope that the board are up for sharing and opening up.
Well, I've got a bureau to run. See you soon. Yes, ma'am, Director Faden.
Please, Emily. Not even as a joke.
If
the files on parasitic entities, I was
I found a couple of those files in Dr. Garland's office. I'd have to dig through the archives for the rest, but I'm not going to not with the altered items loose.
Then go see if any ranger squads are available for a file retrieval. Who moved my waveform with the hiss recording?
Sorry, ma'am. I took them. Darling asked for any visual materials to be stowed for future instructional videos. He asked for anything that looks particularly good in a backdrop.
Inform all research staff that any instructional videos are postponed indefinitely. And don't ever touch my work again. There haven't been any hiss sightings in the Ocean View Motel. Could survivors be hiding inside?
It's possible. I remember a report about a similar incident from 84. The Bureau lost contact with a whole department during a house shift. The department head was found in the motel 2 years later, his arm stuck in the vending machine.
Make a note to send in a search party when possible. Lots to do.
All right. Let's see, is Dylan still up
here? Sounds like she can really handle things.
Finally, someone had the balls to take the fight to them. It's about time we had someone other than an old man at the helm.
Actually, I agree. She's beaten the hiss over and over. If we win this thing, it'll be because of her.
And don't you forget it.
I'll be here waiting for you when you wake up, brother. If you wake up.
And hopefully when you do, you'll be a lot more, well, a lot less insane.
When do you think Marshall's coming back?
He's now head of research. It's official. Marshall's
head. Search? When was the review process? Why weren't we consulted?
Calm down. It's pretty clear she earned it.
And yeah, trust me, the last thing we need around here is another darling. Alright, let's see, before we tackle the hotline chamber, let's see if we can go and find any, let's see. All right, let's see if we can find Underhill and Langston. See if we can pick their brains for a little bit.
Staying with us until the mold is eradicated.
Indeed. Until I find a permanent resolution to this pesky fungus business, I'll be here. Perhaps even beyond that, seeing as you are quite understaffed at the moment.
Fair enough.
Though I hardly have a say in my own comings or goings. Your oldest house won't open the exits until those hiss monstrosities are cleared out.
Glad to have you along for the ride.
For better or for worse.
Will the mold be under control anytime soon?
We were barely containing it with weakly controlled burns. Just look at how it has spread after a few days of non-interference. It's beyond the threshold now. The floodgates are open.
I noticed.
So that's a no.
Americans.
Watch who you're talking to.
With Darling gone, I'm putting Emily Pope in charge of the research sector. Are you okay with that?
Perfectly. You have pulled Excalibur from the stone, and now decree as you see fit, O Queen. What a true meritocracy we live in.
Glad to hear it.
Wow, could you be any more passive-aggressive and sarcastic?
I had a dream. Or something like one. Darling was there. He told me something, but I can't remember what. I think he's gone.
Right. Well, he's never where one expects him to be, is he? Well, thank God. I can finally stop writing these tedious reports that I'm sure he never even took the time to glance at. If you speak to him again, can you tell him I... I hope he found what he was looking for.
I'll try.
I'm sure he did.
I should be getting back to work.
Right.
I'll see you later, Rhea.
Dr. Underhill, if you please.
Right. Underbridges. Got it. All right, with that, Jessie is now officially saddled in as the director. Oh, okay, well, she's finally getting used to being the director. Whatever. All right. So, yeah, next time we're going to pay a little visit to Langston. And, pay a little visit to Langston, see what he knows. And then we'll get started on the Foundation DLC. Although, first things first, gonna do a whole sweep of the place. Of course, avoiding the hotline room, of course. So, till next time, folks. This is David on David's Brain. Stay in sight, stay safe, wear a mask, get vaccinated. Buh-bye!